Welcome to Angel TV and Crossfire.
欢迎你收看安息 TV， 这是十架的火焰系列。
May God bless you in Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior.
愿主耶稣基督的恩惠呢随着你，并且神赐福于你。
Today we're going to talk to you about the hand of God.
今天我们要谈的是神的手。
Reading from 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6.
我们要看的是彼得前书第五章第六节。
Therefore, humble yourself under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time.
所以你们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下，到了时候，他必叫你们升高。
Here Peter exhort us to come under the mighty hand of God.
在这里，彼得劝勉我们要伏在神的大能的手下。
There are a few things that we can consider coming under the hand of God.
当我们论及伏在神大能的手下，有几方面呢是值得我们去思考的。
The hand of God speaks about judgment.
神的手呢，一方面说到神的审判。
In Exodus, the 9th chapter, verse 2 to verse 3.
出埃及记第九章二到三节。
And if you refuse to let them go and still hold them, behold, the hand of the Lord will be on your cattle in the field, on the horses, on the donkey, on the camels, on the oxen, and on the sheep. There will be very severe pestilence.
出埃及记第九章二到三节，你若不肯容他们去，仍旧强留他们，耶和华的手加在你田间的牲畜上，就是在马、驴、骆驼、牛群、羊群上必有重重的瘟疫。
Here, Pharaoh refused to let Israel go.
从这段经文我们看到呢，法老不愿意让以色列民离开。
And here Moses began to say, if you refuse to let them go, the hand of God will come upon the animals.
于是摩西对法老说，如果你不肯容他们去，那么耶和华的手将会加在你田间一切的牲畜上。
Surely this is a stern warning to Pharaoh.
这对法老来说是一个严厉的警告。
As we see from the Bible, Pharaoh did not let the people go, and the judgment of God fell upon Egypt.
从出埃及记我们看到，法老最终还是不愿意让以色列百姓离去，结果呢，神的刑罚重重的降在法老身上以及全埃及。
It's a fearful thing to come under the hand of God in severe judgment.
当我们伏在神的大能的手下，面对神的审判的时候，那是非常可怕的事。
Another portion as we read in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 6.
另外一处的经文我们要看的是历代志下二十章第六节。
If you were to read in verse 3 onwards,
我们可以从第三节开始看。
The Bible says, Jehoshaphat feared and set himself to seek the Lord and proclaim a fast for all Judah.
历代志下二十章第三节开始，约沙法便惧怕，定意寻求耶和华，在犹大全地宣告禁食。
And Judah gathered together to ask help from the Lord from all the cities of Judah. They came to seek the Lord.
于是犹大人聚会，求耶和华帮助。犹大各城都有人出来寻求耶和华。
And then Jehoshaphat stood in the congregation of Judah and Jerusalem in the house of the Lord before the new court.
约沙法就在犹大和耶路撒冷的会中，站在耶和华殿的新院前。
And he says, O Lord God of our father, are you not God in heaven? And do you not rule over all the kingdoms of the nation? And in your hand is there not power and might, so that no one is able to withstand you?
说，耶和华，我们列祖的神啊，你不是天上的神吗？你不是万邦万国的主宰吗？在你手中有大能大力，无人能抵挡你。
Right over here, we find, if you read the scripture, it talks about the people of Ammon and the people of Moab that comes against Jehoshaphat.
当我们读这段经文的时候呢，我们看到亚门人和摩押人他们来对付约沙法。
So here Jehoshaphat believed that the hand of God will be upon his life and against the enemy of Israel.
从经文里头我们看到约沙法他相信神的大能大力会与他同在，神会为着以色列民和亚门人以及摩押人征战。
Right here we find that the hand of God speaks of the judgment of God.
从这里我们也看到呢，这里所指的神的手也是指神的审判。
Another scripture that we see in Ezekiel the 44th chapter verse 12.
接着我们要看的是以西结书44章12节。
Because they ministered to them before the idols and caused the house of Israel to fall into iniquity. Therefore I have lifted up my hands in an oath against them, says the Lord, that they shall bear their iniquity.
以西结书44章12节。因为这些利未人曾在偶像前伺候这民，成了以色列家罪孽的绊脚石，所以我向他们起誓，他们必担当自己的罪孽。这是主耶和华说的。
Right over here in Ezekiel 44 chapter, we find that the priests they were serving in the temple of God.
在以西结书44章里头我们看到呢，祭司原本在神的殿中侍奉神，
began to involve in idol worship.
可是他们却开始敬拜偶像。
And God's anger was against the priests and the hand of God came upon them.
于是神的愤怒临到这些的祭司，神的手也临到他们身上。
This clearly speaks aboutIn our life also that God hates idolatry.
从这里我们也看到呢，神憎恶我们在生命当中有偶像的敬拜。
Idolatry may not necessarily come as a graven image in our life.
所谓的偶像敬拜呢，并不一定呢，是说到一些具体的这些的偶像的敬拜。
Our ministry can become an idol.
我们的侍奉很可能成为我们的偶像。
Our church that we pastor can become an idol.
我们所牧养的教会可能成为我们的偶像。
The people that we govern can become an idol.
我们所管理的人也可能成为我们的偶像。
The people in our, under our care belongs to the Lord.
我们所关顾的人其实是属于主的。
When these become an idol in our life,
可是当这一切都成为我们生命中的偶像，
God is not pleased.
神就不喜悦。
The hand of God also speaks about the protection of God.
论到神的手呢，第二方面那就是指神的保护。
In 1 Samuel the 17th chapter verse 37,
在撒母耳记上17章37节，
Moreover, David said,The Lord who has delivered me from the paw of the lion and from the paw of the bear, he will deliver me from the hand of this Philistine. And Saul said to David, Go, and the Lord be with you.
撒母耳记上十七章三十七节，大卫又说，耶和华救我脱离狮子和熊的爪，也必救我脱离这非利士人的手。扫罗对大卫说，你可以去吧。耶和华必与你同在。
Here David began to testify of the hand of God upon his life in protection.
从这段经文我们看到呢，大卫为着神的手来做见证，因为神的手一直在他的身上呢来保护他。
When the Philistine was coming against Israel,
当非利士人来对抗以色列民的时候，
And there was a man in Philistine by the name of Goliath defying the God of Israel.
在非利士人当中有一个巨人呢，他叫做哥利亚，他在以色列民的面前呢侮辱神。
And here David testified, he said, Look here, if God can hand it upon me to protect from the lion and the bear, the hand of God is upon me to fight against Goliath.
在这段经文里头我们就看到大卫他见证说，既然耶和华的手能够救我脱离狮子和熊的爪，那么他也必会救我脱离这非利士人哥利亚的手。
In 1 Samuel, the 18th chapter, verse 10 to verse 12.
接着我们在撒母耳记上18章第10到12节看到。
Here is the hand of God protecting upon David's life.
这段经文我们看到神的手继续地保守着大卫的生命。
And happened on the next day that the distracting spirit from God came upon Saul, and he prophesied inside the house. So David played music with his hand and at other time, but there was a spear in Saul's hand.
次日从神那里来的恶魔大大降在扫罗身上，他就在家中胡言乱语，大卫照常弹琴，扫罗手里拿着枪。
And Saul cast the spear, for he says, I will pin David to the wall with it. But David escaped his presence twice.
扫罗把枪一抡，心里说，我要将大卫刺透，钉在墙上。大卫躲避他两次。
But Saul was afraid of David because the Lord was with him, but have departed from Saul.
扫罗惧怕大卫，因为耶和华离开自己，与大卫同在。
So here we see, even though Saul desired to kill David because of his popularity,
从这段经文我们看到，由于大卫越来越受欢迎，所以呢，扫罗定义要杀害大卫。
Saul acknowledged that the hand of God was protecting David.
扫罗他承认神的手在保护大卫。
Even David was spared by Saul.
虽然扫罗杀大卫的时候，大卫逃过一劫。
Let us look in the attitude of David in this chapter.
让我们从撒母耳记上十八章来看一看大卫的态度。
In verse 14, the Bible says, "And David behaved wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him."
撒母耳记上十八章十四节，大卫做事无不精明，耶和华也与他同在。
As we look in this verse, it reminds us as we read in 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 6.
当我们读这节经文的时候呢，我们也联想到刚才所读的彼得前书第五章第六节。
Humble yourself therefore under the mighty hand of God, and he will exalt you in due time.
彼得前书第五章第六节说，你们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下。
Here we see later on in David's life, as years passed by, he became the king of Israel.
后来经过了一些时日之后呢，我们看到大卫成为了以色列的王。
So as we see from these scriptures that was given to us,
当我们研读这些的经文，
we need to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God so that we will fulfill the purpose of God in our hearts.
我们要学习的就是要自卑，伏在神的大能手下，好让神的旨意能够成就在我们的生命中。
Just as the disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ came under the hand of Jesus, as years passed, they rose up to become great men of God.
正如主耶稣的门徒一样，当他们与耶稣同在的时候呢，他们伏在主耶稣的大能的手下，直到后来呢，他们成为神所重用的仆人和门徒。
It not only involved in humility, but also a surrendered life.
这不单只说到我们的生命要谦卑下来，更重要的是呢，我们要把自己的生命降服在神面前。
Each day as we walk with the Lord,
每一天当我们与主同行，
God is dealing in our hearts.
神每一天都在那边呢，操练我们的生命。
God is beginning to stir in our spirit man.
神在那边眺望我们里面的属灵人。
So that we may know the hope of his calling in our life.
好让我们能够明白神在我们生命当中呼召的盼望。
Paul began to write to the Ephesian church in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 18.
我们看到使徒保罗写给以弗所的书信，在以弗所书第一章十八节。
The eyes of your understanding be enlightened that you might know what is the hope of his calling, what are the riches of the glory of the inheritance in his saints.
以弗所书一章十八节， 并且照明你们心中的眼睛，使你们知道他的恩召有何等指望，他在圣徒中得的基业有何等丰盛的荣耀。
As Paul writes to the Ephesian believer, the word that we need to emphasize is know the hope of his calling.
当保罗写信给以弗所信徒的时候呢，我们要特别注意这一句话，就是使你们知道他的恩召有何等指望。
The word know in the Greek speaks of to know by experience.
这里的知道呢，在希腊文的意思就是透过我们的经历来明白。
Today we are living in an age where knowledge has begun to increase tremendously.
今天我们所活着的世代呢，是一个知识增长的非常迅速的世代。
As we see the book of Daniel chapter 12,
我们看但以理书十二章。
In Daniel chapter 12 verse 4,
在但以理书十二章第四节。
In Daniel chapter 12, verse 4, But you, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase.
但以理啊，你要隐藏这话，封闭这书，直到末时，必有多人来往奔跑，知识就必增长。
Even though there are many unbelievers in the world who disregard Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior,
虽然在世界上有很多的人，他们都不承认主耶稣基督是救主。
But even as you hear and see this program, you cannot deny in your heart that the prophecy of Daniel is coming to pass each day and each minute today.
可是当你观看这个节目的时候，你无可否认，但以理在这边所说的预言呢，在我们的世代的里面是一天比一天更加的真实。
To gain knowledge is so easy today.
今天要获得知识是那么的容易。
We begin to click on a button on the computer will give us access to vast knowledge.
你只要在电脑上按一个按钮的话，你就可以得到许许多多的知识。
Much knowledge about computer and the latest gadget.
今天在世界上有许多的人对于电脑和这些最先进的科技的器具呢是非常明白的。
Today I felt the Holy Spirit is saying,
今天圣灵在我的心里头好像对我这样说。
In spite of all the knowledge that is in our hands,
我们手中所拥有的所有的知识，
We need to knowThe knowledge of the calling of God in our life.
在这一切之上，我们所要做的就是明白神在我们生命当中的呼召。
We see it in the life of Apostle Paul.
在使徒保罗的生命里头，我们看到。
When he encountered the Lord on the Damascus road.
当保罗在大马色的路上与主相遇的时候。
That journey with the Lord Jesus Christ transformed his life and became the greatest man.In the kingdom of God.
他在大马色路上与主的关系呢，转化了他的生命，让他的生命成为神所重用的一个仆人。
Paul was a very knowledgeable man, but yet he knew the knowledge of God much more.
使徒保罗是一个知识非常高的一个人，不过他对于神的知识呢，却是超越了他属世的知识。
Just as Jeremiah the 29th chapter verse 11,
正如耶利米书二十九章十一节所记载的。
I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you a future and a hope.
耶利米书二十九章十一节。耶和华说，我知道我向你们所怀的意念是赐平安的意念，不是降灾祸的意念，要叫你们末后有指望。
Maybe some of you are struggling in your heart.
或许在我们当中有些人，你的心里正在挣扎。
You may say, I walk with the Lord Jesus.
或许你说，我与主耶稣同行。
And you may say, I don't seem to see the fulfillment of God's purpose in my life.
可是呢，我却没有办法看到神的旨意实践在我的生命中。
But we need to ask ourselves and evaluate in our hearts.
可是我们需要去检查我们的心，然后再一次的来评估我们的心。
Have we properly submit ourselves under the mighty hand of God?
我们是不是完完全全的顺服在神的大能手下呢？
And I believe when we submit ourselves under the mighty hand of God, He will exalt us in due time.
我相信当我们把自己的生命完全的降服在神大能的手中，到了时候，他必然会叫我们升高。
There are many believers, many Christians who love Jesus.
有很多的信徒，很多的基督徒，他们都爱慕主。
Somehow they have failed to submit under the hand of God.
可惜的是呢，他们却没有把自己降服在神大能的手下。
And in these last days that we are living, we need to purpose our heart to fulfill the plan and the purpose of God.
在这末世的时候，我们需要在心中定义，就是让我们的生命呢能够降服在神大能的手中。
In Psalms 91 verse 1,
诗篇91篇第一节，
He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
诗篇91篇第一节，住在至高者隐秘处的必住在全能者的荫下。
Throughout the Bible, we find the reference of the secret place of God.
在整本的圣经的里面呢，我们都发觉到呢，有一个属于神的隐秘处。
And I seem to believe in my heart the secret place is coming under the protection of God's hand.
我心里面深深的觉得，神这一个隐秘处呢，当我们能够躲在神的隐秘处的时候，就会得着神的保护。
Just as we see the Old Testament prophets and the Old Testament priests.
正如我们在旧约圣经里面所看到的那些先知和祭司。
The priests in the Old Testament will enter into the tabernacle of God.
旧约时代的祭司，他们会进入神的会幕中。
It was the secret place in their life.
神的帐幕呢，就是祭司的隐秘处。
That secret place is where the priest is covered by the Shekinah glory of God.
在这个隐秘处呢，祭司们都被神的荣耀给遮盖了。
Jesus also mentioned about that secret place.
主耶稣也曾经提到这个隐秘处。
In Matthew chapter 6 verse 6.
在马太福音第六章第六节。
But you, when you pray,Go into your room, and when you shut the door, pray to your Father who is in secret place, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you openly.
马太福音六章六节，你祷告的时候要进你的内屋，关上门，祷告你在暗中的父，你父在暗中查看，必然报答你。
As I began to ponder upon this scripture,
当我思想这节经文
into the secret place or under the shadow of God
是要进入这个隐秘处呢，还是要躲在神的影子之下呢？
You and I know when we stand under the sun
我们都知道当我们站在太阳底下
and when as we look down
当我们往下看
we will see our own shadow
我们会看到自己的影子。
If anybody wants to get close to us,
任何的一个人若是靠近我们
and see our shadow,
他想看我们的影子
they must come much closer.
他们必须要非常靠近才可以看到。
They cannot stand afar and be overshadowed by my shadow.
他们不可以站得太远，因为我的影子呢会把它遮住了。
Because my shadow isn't that large, so large that it can go that far.
因为我的影子不是那么长，你可以在那边看得到。
The person need to come near.
那个人若是想要看我的影子的话呢，必须要靠近我。
It seems to imply when we come under the shadow, we come closer to God.
这似乎让我看到呢，如果我们靠近神的话呢，我们就是在靠近神的身影。
My shadow is not the real me, but the real me is I myself.
影子呢并不是真正的我，我才是真正的我。
As we come under the shadow of the Almighty,
当我们来到全能者的荫下，
the shadow symbolically speaks about God.
这个荫下呢，它所代表的就是神的意思。
But our heart's desire is not just a shadow, but it is God that we desire more in our life.
其实我们所渴慕的并不是耶和华的荫下，而是所渴慕的是神自己。
Today, is there a desire in your heart to come under the shadow of the Almighty?
今天在你的心里面是不是有这样的一种渴慕，就是要来到全能者的荫下呢？
Today, as we look in the letter of Peter in our life,
今天当我们研读彼得的书信，
It says here, humble yourself therefore and come under the mighty hand of God.
经文告诉我们说呢，所以我们要自卑，伏在神大能的手下。
And I believe this is our desire.
我深信这是我们心中的渴慕。
Let us pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father, I pray right now in Jesus' name.
天父，我这个时候奉主耶稣的名祷告。
Help us to come under the shadow of the Almighty.
主啊，求你帮助我们来到全能者的荫下。
Help us to come under your mighty hand.
让我们能够伏在你大能的手下。
As your word say, you will exalt us in due time.
因为正如你的话语所说的，到时候你就会叫我们升高。
Father, I thank you right now.
天父，我这个时候献上感谢。
For you are helping us and leading us under the shadow, that's where the secret place of God is.
因为你正在带领我们，帮助我们，让我们能够来到全能者的荫下，也就是来到你的隐秘处。
Bless those who are hearing this telecast.
主啊，求你赐福凡观看这个节目的朋友。
In Jesus' name we pray.
奉主耶稣的名我们祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
May God bless you.
愿神赐福于你。
As we continue to humble our hearts and come under the shadow of the Almighty.
当我们在神的面前把我们的心谦卑下来，还有伏在神的大能手下。
As we humble our hearts to come under the mighty hand of God,
当我们谦卑地伏在神大能的手下的时候，
Do write to us and let us know what God is doing in your life.
请你写信告诉我们神在你生命中的大能作为。
For we desire to hear your testimony.
因为我们非常乐意收到您的见证。
God bless.
愿神赐福于你。